Good day everyone and welcome to this webinar, Future Connectivity Changes the Business Model. We hope that everyone is on board and that you will have an interesting time together with us. You will all be muted during this webinar and today we will not have an interactive Q&A. Instead, please use the chat function if you have any questions. We will after the webinar compile the questions and upload them at our web, nolato.com Silicon Technique Webinars. You can also send an email to andreas.karlsson@nolato.com. The webinar starts soon.
The world is changing rapidly around us. It's hard to keep track of all the moving parts. But we at Nolato have always been part of leading the change. Since our beginnings in 1938, in the beautiful nature of Sweden, we helped shape the world as we know it. We've been part in enabling mobile connectivity, 3G, 4G, and now 5G, providing instant communication and connectivity globally. With the help of our production sites located in 5 countries, Nolato provides world-leading conductive silicone that is needed for building 5G network base units, enabling autonomous driving and the electrification of cars. With agile and innovative solutions, Nolato will continue to lead the change as a global company with heart and heritage in Sweden.
Again, warmly welcome to this webinar, Future Connectivity Changes the Business Model. The persons you will meet today is me, Anders Sander, Marketing Coordinator at Nolato Silicon Technique, Anders Eriksson, Managing Director at Nolato Silicon Technique, Peter Brinteson at FKG, Scandinavian Association of Suppliers, Andreas Karlsson, Global Business Manager Telecom at Nolato Silicon Technique. First, we will start with Peter Brinteson. Welcome.
Hi, my name is Peter Brinteson. I work for the Scandinavian Association of Suppliers here in Sweden. And we work for mainly all the suppliers here to improve them. Nolato called me and asked if I could participate in some webinars and talk about the future and especially connected to electrification, of course, where Nolato's main product are focusing on. And I was happy to be asked and gladly to be here with you today. And 3 seminars is quite a challenge to talk, and the last one is about business model, and I was pleased to have that as the last one because we notice in our work that the business model is the key factor for all the changes. If we look at environment, or if we look at car sharing, or if we look at the production, digitalization, industry 4.0, everything ends up in a new business model. So that is really a good way to finish this seminar series of 3. We work a lot to try to change our part of the industry, and we also see that the OEMs are also not quite sure about how the future will look like. This picture, if you see, it's in, unfortunately, in Swedish, but I saw it 2 days ago only, and I believe this is very important. It says 5G, no one understood iPhone. And the same is for 5G. And 5G will definitely change automotive a lot. When we look at what 5G can do and increase data, it's really, really will change the business model a lot. 5G is unfortunately a little bit late in Europe. We see that Asia and US is ahead of us, but we also see that in these areas the 5G really changed the automotive industry. So we hope that we can get started big time here in Europe to 2020. Then we will see a lot of big changes in automotive. When we look at this picture, the global mobility trends and sustainability, and it's really, really a big change. We said that seminar number one, and we said it in seminar number two, and we definitely need to say it here as well in seminar number three, because all we do will be changed. We have done some surveys within our members, and one third of our company's members think they are on track. They believe the change is coming, and they have prepared for it. One third will say they have a big problem with the change, and one third claim that they are not affected at all. And that is the most scary part for us, because we see that everyone is affected of this huge mega trend change. So, and especially when it comes to the business model, the normal way to do business in automotive is that some material supplier send it to a tier two, who send a part to a subsystem supplier, tier one. And then they ship complete subsystem to the OEM, who produce in vehicle and send it to the customer. This will definitely change. The customer will be not only OEMs in the future, it will also be cities, logistic companies, operators, and others. So to be a supplier in the future, it's really, really needed to look in more directions than just the OEMs. We also will see that electrification will change the type of products we produce, and the business case around it. And here is one example of last mile transport in a city. Today we have quite big trucks delivering goods into a city, and often it's a diesel engine in it. And now we see that there is a lot of smaller companies starting to produce more specific products for last mile delivery. And they are smaller to get better access to the city. It's electric to get more access of time in the city, even evenings and nights. And they are quite cheap as well compared to traditional truck. So also in this case, the business model is changed, and the product are produced for that purpose. What we also see is that the turnover today is mainly based on two values, and it's price and it's volume. And here we need to look into more factors to keep up the turnover in the future. Because if we only look at the volume and price, the turnover will, for mainly of the mainly volume of the companies we have today, will go down. And the reason for that is that we need to make mobility more efficient, especially when we move people, but also goods. So the turnover will be, of course, volume and price, but also selling data from our own products and also from production. And very important also is to be a part of the recycling business, and use all this reuse, remanufacturing, and recycle. That will be part of the business plan for the supplier in the future. If you look at the automotive in big terms, the turnover of automotive is around $3,000 billion. And today we can see that 80%, 85% of that is to produce vehicles and do maintenance and spare parts. According to a McKinsey report and some other reports as well, we can see that the turnover until 2030 will be more or less the double. So the turnover in automotive will go up heavily the next 10 years. But what we believe is the automotive industry will only be 20% of that turnover in the future. The rest are other stuff like data. So compared to the mobile phone, we will move to produce Motorola, Nokia phones to iPhone and Samsung, also in the automotive industry. So that is a big change as well, and also a change in the business model. Next chart is a chart showing the average use of a vehicle, passenger vehicle in Sweden. And that is roughly 1,000, or put it in kilometers, is 11,500 kilometers per year we are using a passenger's car in Sweden. And as you can see on this graph, the graph is going down. And if we compare it to a phone we have at home today, a regular line home phone, there will be in a certain time when we say, hey, we don't use that phone anymore, we just use the mobile phone, let's cancel that phone and we don't need it anymore and spare that cost. And in the same way we can see here in the automotive that most probably families will say, hey, we don't need that second car, we can manage with just one car, or we can manage with no car at all and buy that mobility when we need it. So the efficiency in mobility will go up, and we will probably see that we need less products producing mobility. Even of the mobility demand itself will go up. The second picture on here is a vehicle showing lifetime of 1 million kilometer lifetime. And today's business model around the passenger car is that the car is produced to work for 10 years or 300 kilometers, and that is the specification OEM are using today. I know as well a vehicle today average lifetime is around 16 years or 16 and a half year, but still it's the specification for all the suppliers producing parts is that the part should be functional 10 years or 300,000 kilometers. And this business model is quite bad for the environment. That means you buy a product for 30,000 euro every 10th year and scrap it. And this business model will only work in the passenger vehicle industry. If you look at the heavy vehicle, trucks, they are designed to work 1 million kilometer each lifetime, and the business model around the truck is made for that. That's why we can have quite cheap transport. If we should have the same business model for trucks as we have for passenger cars, it will be a disaster for us, as when we buy parts from China or US, the logistic will be very expensive. And so the passenger car will probably or can be the same. We can have a target. There is no technical reason why not we can design a vehicle to reach 1 million kilometers even for passenger cars. And then we Of course, we'll try to not have them from day one be able to do 1 million kilometers. There will be some part, like the seating, that we need to upgrade. We design it for 200,000 kilometers and then change it 5 times during the vehicle lifetime. And here we have, yeah, an example of recycling or remanufacturing possibility also for the supplier, meaning the business model is changed again. So that is possible to do in the future. And if you look at other areas of business like airplane, if you enter a SAS flight in Gothenburg, the plane will probably be much older than the interior or the navigation system or even the engine. So the business model is working, definitely, and it could work also in the automotive industry. And that is what we see. We use a vehicle 4 to 5% of its total usable time, and that is really ineffective. If we compare today mobility for passenger vehicles to a factory, this factory will be out of business immediately because it's very, very ineffective. So yes, the business model again will change, and we will move the business model from the OEMs to other parts in the industry.
Thank you, Peter, for an interesting presentation. Next speaker is Andreas Karlsson, Global Business Manager, Telecom. Andreas will talk about why connected cars need a great network and why 5G is the solution. So welcome, Andreas Karlsson.
Connected cars need a great network. Most predictions are that by 2025, almost every single new car will be connected. A connection to the cloud will be considered as a standard. Toyota says that one of their biggest challenges for connected vehicles is the amount of data transmitting to and from the cloud. Audi expects 5G network will make this download of software to and from the connected vehicles more reliable for the ever-increasing amount of vehicles. Telstra predict that all cars will communicate with each other, with the surrounding infrastructure like stoplights and with pedestrians. The possibilities are unlimited. Connected vehicles will talk to each other and to the road. This will be useful in emergency situations, for example. Imagine a scenario where car A is traveling down a highway at 80 miles per hour. Suddenly, car B pulls out in front of car A. To avoid an accident, the sensor on both cars would need to talk to each other. As a result, car A would brake and car B would speed up in order to avoid a collision. In the near future, everything will be connected: cars, roads, stoplights, etc. There is a big challenge of designing networks that are able to deliver and process the amount of ever-increasing volumes of data. Connected cars needs a great network. We at Nolato Silicon Teknik have had many years of experience working closely together with our customers in the telecom sector. Many of them for as long as over 20 years of close cooperation. You find our thermal and EMI solutions in products from all the market leading network providers, such as Samsung, Ericsson, Huawei, Motorola, Nokia, ZTE, CommScope, etc. Typical applications where we have supported our customers are in radios, basebands, links, antennas, connectors, and many more. We offer thermal and EMI shielding solutions that ensure you the highest quality and most reliable products on the market. Nolato's gaskets have been implemented in a variety of products, exposed to frequencies up to 77 GHz and narrow wavelengths with proven functionality. I would like to take this opportunity to present a few cases where Nolato Solutions has contributed in making a great 5G network. 5G radio street macro. The challenge that operators have in metropolitan areas are to grow their capacity beyond what is possible on their rooftop macro sites. For this, our customer has introduced the street macro layer in the network model. Since these radios are placed in busy urban areas, a smooth and fast installation is needed. There is no time or space for difficult and time-consuming connections. The operators need a perfect designed interface for all the connecting cables. This interface also needs to shield high radio frequencies and solve PIM issues. Nolato developed a cable gland for both IP and EMC protection in the same gasket. This allowed our customer to save important space on their product. But the most important thing was that this solution saved lots of time for operators on site while installing this 5G radio. 5G radio links, ultra wideband transceiver. The demand for next generation connectivity continues to grow. Ultra wideband transceiver is a microwave solution offering fiber-like capacity and ultra low latency on radio links, bringing in 5G connectivity to places where fiber is not an option. This solution provides the market's highest transmit power, the smallest size and power consumption to enable operators to extend their E-band links. Simple to install, deploy and maintain. Due to frequency coverage is extremely high, the requirement of heat dissipation on key chipsets is critical for the equipment. Nolato developed a solution with filler dispensed on a metal can for easy assembly directly on the heatsink as a complete solution, which provides secured function of the solution, meanwhile simplify the process at customer's end. 5G operate on higher frequencies. This boosts bandwidth to increase coverage. Thousands of cells will need to be installed, and advanced antennas with signal processing technology will be required to manage the increase in connectivity and signal density. 5G standards aim to boost speeds by offering more frequency support. Current transceivers have to take turns if they want to transmit and receive data on the same frequency, or the data has to be moved to another frequency to avoid holdups, and this causes congestions. The solution, MIMO. MIMO is a form of antenna that increases efficiency by doubling the number of transmitters and receivers. Massimino Systems have successfully tested up to 128 antennas. This significant boost doesn't come without its challenge. Many signals crossing each other, which could cause serious interference. Nolato's gaskets are tested and approved for shielding high radio frequencies. It has been exposed to frequencies up to 77 GHz with proven functionality. Nolato shielding solution enable massive MIMO function without radio frequency interference. Our customer use all of our techniques, extruded, molded and dispensed gasket in their application with proven success. Thank you all for listening, and I would like to wish you a great summer and stay safe, everybody. Thanks.
Thank you, Andreas, for your presentation. And now some summary for the three webinars that we have run through. How to survive and benefit from the four vehicle megatrends: intelligent vehicles, connected vehicles, electric powered vehicles, and shared vehicles. We have also talked about global mobility trends and sustainability will change the automotive industry in a big way, especially for the supplier industry. And Peter Brinteson talked about the turnover will increase, but only 10% of the turnover will remain from existing products and services. And Andreas talked about vehicles that will be connected to cloud and actually connected to everything. So focus on competence development in the areas of future connectivity, smart city and 5G. Thank you, Andreas and Peter, for your presentations. This time we will not have an interactive Q&A, so questions from the chat will be compiled and uploaded at our web, nolato.com Silicon Technique webinars. You can also send an email to Andreas Karlsson and he will reply to you as soon as he can. And we will also upload this webinar to be able to listen once again. The webinar has come to an end and it's time to say thank you for your time and we hope to see you at our upcoming events later on. We will get back to you with more info, so watch out for email invitations and info at LinkedIn, and welcome to follow Nolato Silicon Technique's company page at LinkedIn. Take care and stay safe, and bye everyone!